Okay, now let's check what happens if we reduce the standard deviation in the exogenous variation that affects x1. So I have reduced it from 1 to 0.1. And initially we had a bias of 0.33, but now let's run everything again with a less exogenous variation x1, and we see we have now a much larger bias. So our estimated coefficient in front of x1 is now almost 2, while the true causal effect is 1. So we have almost a bias of 1 now. Yeah, so it is important to have a lot of exogenous variation in x1 to precisely without a bias estimate our causal effect, at least if we cannot perfectly control for all confounders. Let's look at another example. Let's take a look. Assume we have a very precise proxy. So the noise of the proxy is very little, and so the correlation between the proxy and x2 is super large. So the correlation is almost 1. But let's also assume we have very little variation in sources of exogenous variation in x1. So I even added here a zero more. So we have a super precise proxy, but very, very little sources of exogenous variation in x1. Now the question is, what do you think will be the bias of the resulting linear regression? So will we kind of relatively precisely estimate without little bias the true causal effect, or will we have a substantial bias? It's probably hard to know, but make a guess again.